trip out to Saudi Arabia to begin with. This coming from the New York Times. The fact that the morning after the president fired James Comey, the head of the FBI, he has in the Russians to the White House. He has the Russian ambassador. He has the Russian foreign minister. This is the same morning when the news broke this week over, you know, him sharing classified information with the Russians, and now this. Apparently, the president told the Russians that his firing of James Comey has taken the pressure off. And let me just quote the president, according to the Times, "I just fired the head of the FBI. He was crazy, a real nut job. I faced great pressure because of Russia. That's taken off." Matthew Rosenberg on the byline of this incredible news. Matthew Rosenberg, tell me, how did you learn this? What do you know?
Well, I've got to give credit first to my colleague Matt Apuzzo, who was the guy who got the original tip on this and the original piece of information. And that meeting just becomes more remarkable the more we hear about it. You know, the way we understand this is, you know, people in the meeting take notes, and they circulated their notes around the government, obviously. And in that meeting, Donald Trump, the president, told the Russian foreign minister that he was under an immense amount of pressure and that he just fired James Comey and called him crazy, a real nut job. That was at the same meeting where Trump also shared intelligence with the Russian foreign minister that had come from Israel and that Israel had asked us not to share with any country, our allies, never mind Russia.
And so as we're all just responding to this, another piece of your article includes that some other government official who was briefed on the meeting said, no, this was just what a negotiating tactic when he was talking to Lavrov and pressure he was under.
I mean, that's how they're choosing to portray it.
Yeah.
And that's certainly, you know, it's really one way to look at it. It does seem like an awfully kind of curious way the day after this firing to portray what is by then already an immense controversy in the U.S. and something that, you know, Trump has later has acknowledged that he was thinking of Russia when he fired Comey. This kind of adds to that narrative.
Right. Well, I've been talking to some very smart lawyers here on, you know, talking about intent and what's in the mind of the president as everyone's wondering, okay, well, why would you fire Comey? And now we're getting this detail from your piece on that. And also, Matthew, you know, when we were talking, what was that, a couple days ago, it feels like forever now, on the classified intel that the president apparently shared, that this is, didn't Putin, Vladimir Putin, offered up the transcript to help out the White House, am I right, on this very meeting?
I believe he did, yes. Which, you know, I think everybody's sort of turned down that offer at this point. You know, I'm not a lawyer, so I want to be a little careful here. But it does not. You know, the one thing that's important about this is that these are an official summary of the meeting. So these notes are an official document. This isn't a one person's view of a two person conversation. There were multiple people in the room. This is what the note taker heard and wrote down.
I'm glad you made that point, that it is from this official, you know, memorialization of the meeting. And you're not a lawyer, so I won't put you in a bad spot, but I have a lawyer sitting to my right, Paul Callen. Paul, listening to Matthew, learning about this piece, you know, it's all about intent, right? This is a glimpse into the mind of Mr. Trump and the firing of James Comey.
Oh, yes. It's a very, very clear and strong look at intent. What was extraordinarily inappropriate about the comments, remember, the FBI is doing a counterintelligence operation against the two Russians who were in the room, the Russian ambassador and the foreign minister, to tell them that, in essence, the investigation has now been terminated because I have fired the FBI director and because he's nuts and he's crazy, but words to that effect. Just seems incredible. I mean, it's bad enough that he's having the meeting with them in the first place, but now to tell them that the pressure is off on the Russia probe is really totally inappropriate.
So this news broke, I want to say, some 10 minutes after Air Force One took off from Joint Base Andrews, and is now the president is heading off on this very, very important first overseas trip, first stop to Saudi Arabia. And so let's go to Nick Robertson, who actually is near where the president will be staying there in Riyadh. And we've been talking so much about, you know, the controversies thus far. are swirling, and maybe this opportunity to go overseas will could help the president. But this meeting with the Russians, Nick, it just continues to get more surreal.
It's going to come up and it's going to dog him here. Obviously, he's going to be asked questions about it, but it gets to that deeper issue of when President Trump is in a room with other officials, how does he behave? How does he respond with them? And there is a real danger that while he's here in Saudi Arabia with the king, who, by the way, is essentially rolling out the red carpet, has plastered the road with flags of the United States and Saudi Arabia together, who has huge billboards by the highway that President Trump will see, that has him, King Salman, and President Trump side by the side, and is illuminating President Trump's hotel behind me with the stars and stripes and the image of President Trump, has put a lot on the line here. But when they get behind closed doors, when they have their meetings, and remember there will be up to as many as 35 other regional Arab and Muslim leaders here as well, what is the level, if you will, of hubris that goes on behind those closed doors? What do his allies here say to him that potentially will put him in an awkward situation like this if the meeting is reviewed under close scrutiny, as this meeting was with Lavrov and Kisilyak? You know, that from that perspective, behind the closed doors, he may be away from the prying questions of journalists saying, did you do this? Why did you do this? But he may be behind those doors exposing himself to further opportunity to stray from the norm, if you will, of normal, we use that in inverted commas, past presidential behavior, rather, Brooke.
Mm-hmm. Nick, in Saudi Arabia, thank you, covering this incredibly significant trip for the president. Let's go.